Hello and greetings from Iceland. Like many of you might know already, eruption number 9 just started and the fissure is now around 1.5 kilometers long. But we expect that to change in the next 3-4 hours. And this eruption, it started strong. The town, Grindavik, was evacuated before this took off full force. So the families that were in town, they are all safe. And overall, this eruption looks very much the same as the last two eruptions. So I don't see a reason to be too technical right now, because the important thing to think about now is where will the lava flow. And right now, it seems as we got lucky. And due to how dark it is outside now, and all we see is the orange stuff, I am going to use this video I shot recently to explain things a bit better. And the fire, it came up right here. And the highest point on the Sundenhugar craters is around here. And that is very important because that will determine if the lava is going to flow to the north or the south into the town. And as things look now, the lava will flow beside this mountain and beside those barriers where we have water pumps now. And we can see it already that the lava is getting very close to this highway that has been covered, I think, 3 times so far, or just by the intersection to the Blue Lagoon. And what I think now is that this will be the main battle station all night and tomorrow. And if the lava will go over those walls, there is just straight path for it down to the power plant. And if that goes, the Blue Lagoon goes. And we have been told that this is the largest amount of magma so far that has accumulated under there. And I can see it already. It's a huge amount of lava coming up right now. So there are really no surprises tonight. So far, this looks as the best possible outcome for the town, although we can't rule out that the fissure will stretch further south tonight. But as we know from prior eruptions, it will start to form craters within a few hours, and most likely before I will reach the south coast, here from the north. So as usual, I'm leaving links to the webcams and Icelandic news sources in English. There are no delays when it comes to flights, as usual. Those eruptions have never interrupted air traffic. So if you are a tourist in Iceland, don't be worried. This is just how my country is. And I cannot promise what kind of footage I will capture this time. It will depend on how close I can get. And my main goal is to get something different with the equipment I have. So when I finish this upload, I will throw the rest of my stuff into the car, buy myself a large cup of coffee, maybe 2 of them for the road. And my intention is to get some photos before it gets bright. I would really like to capture some night footage from this. It also depends on how long time I can stay in Reykjavik and how the eruption develops. But I expect that this will turn out like last time. In 24 hours, there will be a few craters active, in 3 days, maybe 1, and it might go on for 1 or 2 weeks. And my focus will be on the lava flow the next hours and days. Is the magma more than we can handle with those lava walls and extremely powerful water pumps to cool the lava? But this is enough for now. My goal is to make the next update tomorrow. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.